Guys, welcome to another exciting video at the Craft Read channel. I'm going to be talking about something which is very new to me, and that is 3D decoupage. These beautiful sheets were recently launched by Craft Read, and I'm very excited to try my hand at it because I've never really done 3D decoupage with the ready-made sheets. I will show you one project which I had done some time back. This was a tag which I had created for an alt-new blog hop, and you can see I have popped up the flowers here. I cut them apart and popped them up so that the whole thing has a very 3D look to it. But this is pretty much, you can say, sort of a trial thing because these are stamps and which I separated, but now Craft Read has come out with these 3D decoupage sheets, which are really nice. I will just show you the designs. This is one. This is the second one. Then there is lilies. There are a lot of florals. I really love this one. My fellow deity Parvati has already done a very nice detailed video showing you how to use this. And this is probably my favorite set out of the whole thing because, you know, it's cake and coffee. So let's open it and see. Now, this is how the whole package comes. It has a set of three A5 sized sheets, and it also has detailed instructions. So let's open the package and see. These papers are nice and thick and slightly glossy. Now this particular design is called cakes and coffee, and it basically has two sections. There is one section with a cake on it, and then the second section which has a coffee cup and some pastries and stuff. And if you hold it up, you will see there is a very thin line here. So that you can just cut along that and separate the two. And then there are two more sheets. One sheet has all the details to put together the coffee cup. So you basically need to cut these apart and use them. And then you have another set for the cake. So the idea is, this is the base of the design, and then you have all these, you cut apart all these smaller pieces, you shape them, and then you stack them up with foam tape or silicone glue, so you get a very nice three-dimensional effect. So now let's proceed with our 3D decoupage. Okay, so let's start with the 3D decoupage. I've basically cut this piece out, just cut it with a craft knife on the side. This is the base. I'll put this away for now. And the other sheet, I've just cut out each individual pieces so it's easier for me to trim them. And I also have this little basket in which I'm going to keep everything so that I don't lose things. This is the largest piece. And I also have two scissors here and a craft knife with a fresh blade. This needs to be really sharp. So the first step is very easy. I just basically need to carefully cut around the outline of the entire thing. I'll be speeding up most of this process because, I mean, it just takes time, you know, and it's nothing too great. You're just basically cutting around. The way I like to do it is, initially I cut a broad outline around the piece I want to cut. One tip while you're cutting it is, don't move the scissors so much. Try to move the paper while you're, especially when you're getting into areas which are very intricate. That helps you get a better cutting line. And take your time over the step, because if you are neat with this, rest of your project is sure to look nice. If there are areas which you feel are too intricate to cut with your scissor, just leave them. You can always come back with your craft knife and cut into them. See, now here, I will leave this smaller area and I'll come back and do it. Okay, now most of the paper is cut out. Now for these inner areas as well as this little bit here which I can't comfortably get with my scissor, I will use my craft knife. So I have my old cutting mat here. Just make sure you keep a cutting mat beneath your paper because it will just make your cutting easier and it will also go smoother. And here our first initial piece is done. This is the little bit of the sugar cube which I put on the side. So I'll put this aside and repeat the same thing for rest of these pieces. All these pieces, I will repeat the same thing. Okay, now all our pieces are ready and we will just do a little bit of touch up. So what I have here is distress inks in 3 shades. I've just taken a few shades of brown that I had and a blending brush, and these are the pieces which are ready. Just make sure you keep track of where all of them are because you can't afford to miss any of them. And now what I'm going to do is, this is the biggest piece I have, I will take the light rust distress ink. This is the rusty hinge. And I will just apply a little bit of distress ink to the sides. Use a very light hand when you do this because you don't really want to change the color of the piece too much. You just want it to have a little bit of definition at the edges. So I'm just going to use it to wherever the lighter brown pieces are. Also, what happens is when you do this, if you have missed any little areas and there is white showing through, the ink will just cover them up so that they won't look show up that dark. See. Anyway, most of this piece is going to be covered. So I will move on to the other pieces now. Just be careful because this paper is a little thin, so you know, you don't want it to fold really too much, especially this little tip here. I'm not doing anything with the ice cubes because they're honestly too tiny and I have something else planned for them. I'll just add a little bit of darker color here. And let's put the inks away. I will carefully place the papers here and I'll just remove my mat. Now the next step is to shape our paper. So I'm going to turn it upside down. And this is what you need to do. This is something called a ball tool. It has this metal ball at the end which you use for shaping. And otherwise, if you don't have that, you can use something like this. This is a pen which has a pretty rounded edge. But honestly, the ball tool is just easier to work with. But if you don't have one, go for this. You can also buy the entire kit that of stuff which you need for 3D decoupage. At the craft shop at a very good special price of just 1000 rupees. So do check that out if you don't have the basic materials, the tools that you need for this. Now when you start using the ball tool, what happens is the paper starts getting soft. Just we use a light hand, because if you make it too hard, it'll start tearing. So it just gives a little bit of roundness to your paper. Just move the ball tool in a circular motion. Okay, so this has a little bit of roundness. That is what will give your whole 3D decoupage a more dimensional look. So I will put this aside in my little dabba and take the other things. And this you can control, you know. Now something like this, which is a very rounded pastry, like a chocolate ball or something, just apply a little more pressure so that the whole thing is a little more rounded. Now once this is done, I will put this aside and we can start actually assembling our decoupage. Okay, now let's start by assembling our card. This is our ready panel on which we've done the 3D decoupage. And first thing I'm going to do is take a corner rounder and just round the corners. Now what I'm going to do is, I have these two pieces of black cardstock. I'm basically using two pieces because I didn't have a long enough piece. The measurement is, this is 5 1/4 inches wide, both the pieces, and then this part is 1 inch, and I've just coded at the 1 inch line, and this total length is 6 1/2 inches. Same with this. This is 6 1/2 inches, and then this is 1 1/2 inch and 1 1/2 inch. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to glue these two like this to create like a so. Let's just put some glue on this. So now let's prepare the sentiment area first. I have this is a corrugated paper which I have and craft. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to add foam tape behind because I want to raise it up slightly. My foam tape is pretty thick. I'm just going to cut off small pieces. I'll just measure so that I know round about where I need to put the foam tape. Let's remove the release paper now. So see, now I've put it so that it's round about centered over this area. Press this, and then I'll just turn it over and take my scissor and cut it off. So this is how our card will sit once it's done. Now let's prepare the front panel. Front panel is easy. We have the 3D decoupage panel which is prepared. And I have this red mat which I've cut, which is slightly larger than the... It's become a rather large sized card, so I'll be making a separate envelope only for this card. But I didn't want to waste even a little bit of this beautiful panel. That is the 3D decoupage panel. Just make sure you glue this down very well because it's a little heavy because of all the layers that we put on. I'm going to just center this carefully. And don't put too much pressure on top of the layers. because you know that will squash them and it will lose the beauty of your project. So gently. And the final step is putting the sentiment. So I've already cut the sentiment which says thinking of you, and I'm going to simply center it here. You can also put a small green colored paper here for writing the sentiment, or you can write it with a white gel pen, whatever suits you. So when the card is folded, this is how it will go in a box. We'll need a box envelope for this. So this is what it looks like in the envelope, and when the person takes it out, he or she can easily prop this and it becomes a easel card. Let me just tip this a little bit for you to see. Like that. So for that, our card, easel card with 3D decoupage is ready. If you want to, you know, sparkle this up, you can just add a few embellishments maybe. You can also add a little bit of stenciling behind if you want. Whatever, I mean, there are so many things, so many ways that you can go with it. I might just add some sparkle here on the sugar cubes to make them shine. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and you will explore this new craft and check out these new 3D decoupage sheets from CraftReed. And looking forward to seeing you at my channel again with a brand new video for CraftReed. Thank you. Bye.